A very good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Chungbae Gymnasium in Chengdu for the medal session in the sparring form of the Chinese martial art of Wushu. Here are the six gold medal contests coming up. It's two in the women's categories that will begin us, then four in the men's categories. We range from 52 kilograms up to 80 kilograms today. This under 52 kilograms is going to begin at real speed, so pay close attention, everybody. The punching and kicking is about to begin. So Ruggeri of France is on the right, and Florentina of Indonesia is on the left. Indonesia in red, France in blue. Florentina gets to business, and she has a decent front leg attack, of course, and she gets the first takedown. So 2 points certainly on the board, and that's a front leg kick to the chest, which has scored. And Ruggeri is then into a clinch, and she's hit again. A couple of points scored onto the chest from Florentina, who's, by my judge, having the better of this first round, and she's again got her opponent to the floor, but it'll only be 1 point there. Florentina looking for the bell here. She knows she's got this first round on the board for her, and it's been really rare in this competition to see anyone come from one round down and take victory. So that start for Florentina leaves her in such good stead. If she wins the next round now, she wins the gold medal. That's one to the chest from that front foot of Florentina. Gets one on the thigh there for another point. Now looking for another takedown, gets it. 1 point as she was taken down herself. No fireworks just yet. But the rigmarole of some decent work has put Florentina in a good position. That's the first moment we've seen Florentina hit the deck without Ruggeri doing so as well. So, nice two-pointer for the French woman. Slower pace will suit Florentina. She's going to choose her attacks now. Be selective. The rush of blood from round one has ebbed an ever so small amount, and it's brought a clarity back to Florentina. She's not going to let that front leg get near her and risk being knocked down again. Much closer round two. Could well be a split decision between the judges. A couple of more shots landing, and if Florentina can get that final takedown in these last seconds. That's the spinning punch. It doesn't quite land to the head. She waited to the very last seconds to throw it. And she might have got something from it. This could be really close. It is close, but it's scored in favor of Florentina. It's gold for them. It's gold for Indonesia, and gold for Farissa Dia Florentina. The medalists in the women's under 52 kilograms. The gold to Indonesia's Farissa Dia Florentina. The silver to France's Maiwen Ruggeri. The next fight's on the platform. It's the women's under 60 kilogram final. Here we go. Li of China in the blue and Tut of Turkey in the red. First attack from Li. Went for the thighs of Tut. That's a scoring area when you land with your leg attacks. Scores just the 1 point that. And Li bouncing around, keeping her target on the move. Tut looks for that first leg attack, but then rather regrets that decision. She's under pressure again. Big throw. First takedown of the final. 2 points secured with that attack for the Chinese fighter, who is looking so composed out there, even as she takes a hammering from that right fist to the head. Can't score points when you're in the clinch, so fighters have to come apart again. And look at this, moving in and then dumping Tut on the floor. She's capable of anything, going down for a foot sweep almost, and now she's twined the leg in between and scored with a foot sweep. And what a composed first round this is going to be from Ju. Brilliantly managed. Hardly a shot fired from Tut other than a couple of close quarter punches landed. First round to Ju. We go on, but Lee is already with one big glove around the gold medal. She's not going to relent here, but Tut at least lands a shot or two. So Lee looking for again a takedown, and she works those body dynamics so well. And her tactics haven't changed in the second round at all. It's a dedicated and structured fight from Lee. A couple of points looking to be added here, and they are. And with every punch, Lee's stature is growing, and that's a clever way to score. Final 25 seconds, more a coronation than anything now. Number of takedowns that she's secured here, racking up. Lee Jusin, here's the pips. And full credit to Berna Tut, who keeps coming. And she's going to stay in this contest all the way to the end of round two at least. And it's victory for China. It's victory for Lee Jusin of the People's Republic of China. And things don't come more comprehensive in Sander than that. Another unanimous decision. Again, several judges not scoring any points at all to Berna Tut. The medalists in the women's under 60 kilogram. The gold medal won by Lee Jusin of the People's Republic of China. Our attention's now turned to the men's competition, starting with the under 52 kilogram category. Demers is a cannier fighter. He uses a lot of feints, especially with his lower leg. He uses that to fool his opponent, then come in, but he's tipped up here early on. What a beginning. Frustrating for the Turkish fighter not to have landed either of those two takedowns. He's going to be put on the deck again. Oh, he's fast. Pratama is oh so quick. And by standing on his feet during that takedown, ensured he got 2 points rather than one, and DeMercy is going to land something of himself here. DeMercy dominating the center, looks to wedge that hip into his opponent and throw from that position. Big attack onto the thigh, now he's into the leg, and he's going to push Pratama over. Not quite. Well, if he'd landed all these attacks and scored off them, DeMercy would be leading this first round. As it is, it's a close call at the moment. Five judges scoring this first round around the table. If there is a majority, which of course there has to be with five judges, that fighter takes the rounds. Doesn't have to be unanimous. A split decision is still a decision. And it is a split decision, but it's in the favor of the Indonesian. Four judges have scored it to him. Just the one judge awarding that round to Demerci. Big front foot from the Indonesian, who has that extra range, which allows him to keep a bit more distance, and he's got both legs, and he's got another takedown. And he just held his own feet to ensure it was 2 points rather than one. amazing how Demers is dominating the geography of the fight. He's marching Pratama around until Pratama wants to score. And when he wants to, that's the result. Another takedown for Pratama, and he's riding this out. Doesn't have to do too much from here, Pratama. Just has to avoid being knocked out. Straight knockout, the only way for Demers to win this. It's been second best in round number two by distance, actually. So seconds away. And a final point or so scored by Laxmana Pandu Pratama. So the gold medalist, that's in the bag. It's unanimous from the judges. It's a second gold of the night for Indonesia. And Laxmana Pandu Pratama has won the men's under 52 kilograms. The medalists in the men's under 52 kilograms. The gold medal to Laxmana Pandu Pratama of Indonesia. The silver medal to Mehmet Demers of Turkey. It's time for the men's under 60 kilogram final. Ma Yigu, Bintang, Raindra, Nada, Gitara. This will be fascinating. Ma of China is in the red, and Gitara of Indonesia is in the blue, and Ma looks to score first. Not sure if he landed that one. Crowd's reaction urged him to do so. He might land this. Got that leg up from where he could tip his opponent over, but Ma not quite managing it. Gitara is looking for that throw, and it's a simultaneous down, surely. Gets sucked in here and gets put down. Kick to the thighs, by the way. That's worth a single point, and that's what Ma goes for there. It's part of a combination to try and then throw. This is Ma's round, unless Gitara can do anything about it. Ma keeps his distance. Unanimous decision for that round in favour of the Chinese fighter in red. And the task has just got a whole lot harder for Gitara in the blue. He's going to have to pull out every trick in the book across these 2 minutes. He's got the leg. Going up to the head, of course, rescuing that leg taken. And that's another two-pointer for the Chinese fighter. Gitara now gets the leg. He's on the head. That's usually his method. Gitara keeps showing attacking intentions, but not the prowess to score points. Needs something big here. Probably needs a knockout in these final seconds. Not going to get it. He's off the platform, and whether that's a judge to have been points scored or not is up to the judges, but Ma Yigu celebrates, and he knows he's won. Another unanimous decision from the five judges. Ma Yigu and the People's Republic of China with the gold in the men's under 60 kilograms. The medalists in the men's under 60 kilograms. The gold medal to Ma Yigu of the People's Republic of China. The silver medal to Bintang Raindra Nada Gitara. Sahandi of Iran is in the red, and Her of China in the blue. China against Iran for the gold medal in the men's 70 kilograms. Sahandi comes forward powerfully, so just head on. Nothing subtle about that from the Iranian. Laying down a physical marker. So square onto his opponent. Shows what he's up for, shows his intentions, and he's releasing hurtful punches. Trying to sting them into his opponent. Now he's got that front leg after the attack. Both fighters looking to score with a takedown, and Sahandi gets it. That's a big, powerful left leg going through the defense from Sahandi quite easily. He wants to get in and throw, Sahandi. Been successful once. If he could get another before the bell, maybe this first round will be his. But Her has come back into it in this second minute. It could be close on the judges' scorecards. Nothing landing at the end net. So Sahandi has been shut out. It's close in the first round. It's closer than anyone has come to a Chinese fighter in this medal ceremony, or in this medal contest, excuse me, but it's still not close enough. Hamidreza Sahandi goes back to it, knows what he needs to do. He needs to come out metaphorically swinging and literally. And he is. Looks to grab that front leg, doesn't quite get it. Needs multiple takedowns to put this beyond doubt, but he's struck with one. By Her. Executed to perfection. That big arm round the neck and then a hip movement. Back spinning punch, which doesn't land from Sahandi. Hundred seconds remaining in this second round. Oh, he's got him. He's caught him. And those reflexes do the job.
Blue side down.
2 points indisputably to the Iranian. And now he saunters forward with his brow furrowed and a little more courage as he looks again for a takedown. Now this is getting interesting. Oh, he pops one to the chest and almost replies. That is just how good this man is. He can take a hit like that and still capture the leg. Now he comes in, looks for another combination. Kick into a takedown, which doesn't work. He's up to the head, he's landed that one. And a punch to follow. These last 20 seconds are still important in this round. It could swing in the Chinese fighter's favor. He's got to score again, Sahandi. He's got to score again, he's going to be scored on. And that might just be the gold medal. For Her Fong. Last 10 seconds, if Sahandi can't reply, this could be it. The pips will tick out here and he's down again. And that really is it. Case closed. Gold medal in the books. Her Fong with his arms in the air. And it's a unanimous decision, which needed those two takedowns. From the Chengdu Sports University, it's a fourth gold medal. And this one is for Her Fong. Chinese gold again in the Wushu. Silver for Hamidreza Sahandi. The medalist in the men's under 70 kilograms. The gold medal won by Her Fong of the People's Republic of China. The silver by the Islamic Republic of Iran's Hamidreza Sahandi. The gold medal match between Ali Khorshid Arabi of the Islamic Republic of Iran and Lu Wenlong of the People's Republic of China. has that world champion tag from 2019, Kostya Daravi, in the red. Oh, it's been lifted up here and dumped on the canvas. And he was caught, brilliantly so, by Liu, who goes again. It's a double takedown. The second one only scoring 1 point as he went to the floor himself. But Kostya Daravi stung. And the Iranian now looks a little slow, but he'll still land the two there. His first takedown, and nicely done. Now he's being taken by both legs once more, and he's put to the floor. So how will judges score this one? No one has beaten a Chinese fighter in a round yet today, and still that remains. Liu winning the round unanimously. Oh, he's got the leg, Kostya Daravi, and he'll score the first 2 points of the second round. He's got to score and keep scoring. So, yellow card against Kostya Daravi, that means a point to his opponent. Couple of attempts to get single points from leg attacks to the thighs. No one landing anything. Oh, he's gone low. And he's put him to the floor with a trip. Another good work from Liu, and this is what we've seen from so many Chinese fighters. These final 10 seconds are when they take the fight away from their opponent, if there's any doubt at all. Liu Wenlong waits his turn, bides his time, and just knocks Kostya Daravi to the floor, to the end. And Liu Wenlong back to his corner for the victory. It's unanimous once more. Ali Kostya Daravi, unable to conjure his heroics of the World Championships in 2019 and defeat Chinese opposition in China. He has to settle for second best. It's a fourth gold of the session for the People's Republic of China. The medalist in the men's under 80 kilograms. The gold medal won by Liu Wenlong of the People's Republic of China. The silver medal by Ali Kostya Daravi of the Islamic Republic of Iran.